Krishna. So I could not hear what Kanai Krishna Prabhu spoke. Hope I'll not repeat, but repetition is also part of our Krishna consciousness. What PBS Acharya spoke, we just repeat. So Radhashtami is the very special day. It's not very special. It's the most important day. Most auspicious day. Most divine day for the whole creation. And it is very, very sweet for Gauriya Vaishnavas. Because all of us know the devotees of Vishnu, they are known as Vaishnavas. Those who are devotees of Krishna, they are known as Karshna. And those who are devotees of Gauri, Srimati Radharani, they are known as Gauriya. We are all Gauriya Vaishnavas. Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur used to say, we worship Krishna because Radharani worships him. We are interested in Radharani. Whatever she does, we are the servants of her. That is the mood of our parampara. So one of the Prabhupada disciples, early days of ISKCON, asked Srila Prabhupada a question about Srimati Radharani. And Prabhupada said, who are you to ask question about Srimati Radharani? What qualification you have? So if that is the situation to Prabhupada's disciples, so what about us, especially me, a conditioned soul rotting in Maya, talk about Srimati Radharani? Radharani is the most chaste lady, and our tongue is unchaste, so we are not fit to talk about Radharani. But still, today is very special day, merciful day, and Srimati Radharani is always merciful. But generally, on birthday, people become more merciful, most merciful. So on Radhashtami day, Radharani is very, very merciful, and taking that opportunity to get her blessings and mercy, and for our purification and for my purification especially, we'll discuss something about Srimati Radharani. Just like Krishna is unlimited, Radharani is also unlimited. It is said that when Radharani looks at Krishna, Krishna's beauty increases. And when Krishna looks at Radharani, Radharani's beauty increases. That's why nobody can know Krishna. Even Krishna cannot know Krishna, because he is always expanding. So Radharani is also like that, because there is no difference between Radha and Krishna. Chaitanya Charitamrita explains that Radha Krishna Pranaya Vikriti Ladini Shakti Rasmat. Ekatmanavapi Bhuvipura Deha Vedam Gatauta Chaitanya Akhang Prakata Madhuna Taddayang Chaikam Aptam Radha Bhavaduti Subalitam Naomi Krishna Sarupam. So Krishna is one, but for experiencing Lila, experiencing love, he became two. Same. So Pranaya Vikriti. Bikar, transformation of love. Pranay means love. Vikriti means transformation. Just like when the milk is transformed, it becomes yogurt. Like that. So when that love is in unmanifest form, that is within Krishna. And when that love takes a form, that form is Srimati Radharani. So Srimati Radharani is the embodiment of love. Her body is made of Krishna Prema. Our body, sadhaka's body, especially conditioned soul's body, is made of lust. But her body is made of love. That is the difference, big difference. So who can talk about her? Nobody can talk about her. But we are trying, attempting to speak something about her so that we become purified. So Ramananda Rai and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they are talking in South India. Kubur, right? At the bank of Godavari. What? Rajmundry. So they are talking. You know that Ramananda Rai is very confidential associate of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Three and a half associates, most confidential associate. Sare teen parshad means three and a half associates. So who are those? Rai Ramananda, Swarup Damodar Goswami, Sikhi Maiti, and Madhavi Maiti. Three and a half. So Swarup Damodar and Ramananda Rai used to discuss with Chaitanya Mahaprabhu the most confidential pastimes of Krishna in Gambira. So that same Ramananda Rai, when he met Chaitanya Mahaprabhu first time, there was a conversation. It's beautifully explained in Chaitanya Charitamrita. And Mahaprabhu is asking question and Ramananda Rai is replying those questions. So first question Mahaprabhu asked, that what is the ultimate goal of our life? Very good question. Goal of life, we should all know. So Mahaprabhu is asking Ramananda Rai, what is the goal of our life? And Mahaprabhu, Ramananda Rai replied, Swadharma acharane Vishnu bhakti hai. So goal of our life is to perform our occupational duty. Why it is important? Because by performing occupational duty, Vishnu bhakti is awakened in our heart. And that is the goal of our life. Then Mahaprabhu replied, Iyo bahyo age kaho ar. We should not undermine anyone because Mahaprabhu said, Iyo bahyo. It's not that. He's trying to establish something higher. And why he is telling bahyo, that is also very significant. He commented three things. Iyo hoy, first is Iyo bahyo, then Iyo hoy, and Iyo uttam. Why he said that, we'll explain also. So Iyo bahyo means by performing these activities, you cannot enter into the spiritual world. You will be out of the spiritual world. That's why Mahaprabhu is telling Iyo bahyo. These are very important. But by performing this, you cannot enter into the spiritual world. That's why Mahaprabhu is telling Iyo bahyo. So Iyo bahyo age kaho ar. Then Ramananda Rai said, Krishna karmarpan sarva dharma sar. The essence of all practices is Krishna karmarpan. We have to offer our activities to Krishna. Jat karasi jadasi 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 jat. Jat tapasasi kanteya tat kurusa madarpanam. Bhagavad Gita explains, whatever we do, whatever we eat, whatever we offer, that should be done for Krishna. That is Krishna karmarpan. Then Mahaprabhu said, Iyo bahyo. Age kaho. This is external. Please speak something further. Speak something more. Then Ramananda Rai said, Swadharma tyag. That is the goal of our life. Give up our occupational duty. Sarva dharman parityajya maam ekam saranam braja aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayami maa shuchah. That is ultimate instruction of Bhagavad Gita. And Mahaprabhu is telling, Iyo bahyo. We should not think, oh, then Bhagavad Gita lovers will say, what you are talking? Once I was giving a comparison of three books, Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam and Chaitanya Charitamrita. I was talking about Mahaprabhu and Chaitanya Charitamrita. This is a story from Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. If there is a big flood, lot of water. So you cannot carry any things. Then you must carry three things: Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, and Chaitanya Charitamrita. So in our home also these three books must be there to carry. Okay? Then the water level started increasing, so you cannot carry all three. You have to give up one. Then you should give up what? Bhagavad Gita. And that lover of Bhagavad Gita did not like it. It's not undermining anyone. We are trying to establish something superior. Then water level started increasing more and more. Then you cannot carry both. You have to give up one. And Bhagavatam lovers will definitely not like it. Then you should give up Srimad Bhagavatam. Then water level still increasing. What to do? What to do? Then you cannot carry anything. But it is said, even if you cannot edit anything, you cannot give up Chaitanya Charitamrita. You better die in the water, but never give up Chaitanya Charitamrita. And Prabhupada also said, when I was in Jaladuta, my only solace is Chaitanya Charitamrita. That is Gaudiya Vaishnavism, topmost literature of our line. Prabhupada used to say the PhD study of Vedic literature. So coming back to the point again, yo bahyo does not mean undermining anything. We are trying to establish something superior. So sarvadharman parityajya, Mahaprabhu said, yo bahyo age ko hoar. Then what to do? Ramananda Rai had to continue. Because Mahaprabhu is talking actually. Mahaprabhu is asking question and Mahaprabhu is answering through Ramananda Rai. Then Ramananda Rai said, jnana mishra bhakti sarva sadhya sar. You know there are two kinds of bhakti. Mishra bhakti, Shuddha bhakti. So mishra bhakti is also two types, karma mishra, jnana mishra. There is also yoga mishra, other mishras are there. But primarily karma mishra and jnana mishra. We have two desires, desire of enjoyment and desire for liberation. When you have desire for enjoyment, that is called bhakti. And when you have desire for liberation, that is called mukti. So karma mishra bhakti is for enjoyment. Jnana mishra bhakti is for liberation. Both are not eligible to take you to the spiritual world. So jnana mishra bhakti is also, Mahaprabhu is telling, iyo bahyo. So how come mukti is iyo bahyo? How it can be external? So Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, if you are out of the material world, doesn't mean you are in the spiritual world. He's very brilliantly commenting. Because Sahajya Mukti is merging into the effulgence. So effulgence of the body of the Lord is in between the spiritual world and the material world. So you are in Brahma Jyoti does not mean you are in the spiritual world. You are also not in the material world. You are in limbo. In between. That is called Sahajya Mukti. And by Jnana Mishra Bhakti, we can attain that platform. That's why Mahaprabhu said, Iyo Bahyo Age Kaho Aar. Then Ramananda Rai said, Jnana Sunya Bhakti. Means Shuddha Bhakti. Sarvadhas Dasar. Sanna Vilasita Sunyam Jnana Karmadi Anabritam Anukullana Krishna Anushalanam Bhakti Ruttama. That bhakti which is free from desires of bhakti and mukti, which is uncovered by karma and jnana, and the desire is to please Krishna, that kind of bhakti is uttama bhakti. And when Ramananda Rai spoke about that bhakti, Mahaprabhu said, yo hoy. Now you are into the spiritual world. You entered into it. So only by performing Shuddha bhakti we can enter into the spiritual world, not by mishra bhakti. Then we know that Shuddha Bhakti has also three different levels. Sadhana Bhakti, Bhava Bhakti and Prema Bhakti. And Sadhana Bhakti is also of two types. Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti and Raganuga Sadhana Bhakti. And people have a lot of confusion about Raganuga Bhakti. People think Raganuga means Prema Bhakti. That is the first confusion. Raganuga Bhakti is also Sadhana Bhakti. And Vaidhi Bhakti is also Sadhana Bhakti. So what is the difference? Also very much, very clearly explained by Rupa Goswami. And I think devotees should have very clear understanding about that. We think Raganuga Bhakti means changing the process. Raganuga Bhakti means changing the place. We have a lot of ideas about Raganuga Bhakti. But there is no difference between Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti and Raganuga Sadhana Bhakti in terms of activities. Both are same. But internal consciousness changes. Inspiration changes. And what is Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti? Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti means when we perform devotional service out of Shraddha in the words of the spiritual master and in the words of the scriptures. When devotional service is performed on the basis of Shraddha, that is known as Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti, where there is no attraction for Krishna. And when we perform Sadhana Bhakti based on Lobha, means spontaneous attraction, that is known as Raganuga Bhakti. And when we can start Raganuga Bhakti, when our natural attraction will be developed. And when that will develop, when we come to the platform of Nishtha Bhakti. Unless and until we reach the level of Nishtha, there is no question of Raganuga. And if you prematurely do Raganuga, then you are Sahajiya. Taking Raganuga Bhakti cheaply. Prabhu, I am Raganuga now, no more Mangalarti. Because I am in a Raganuga platform. Raganuga platform does not mean you change your activities. Raganuga Bhakti means you change the quality of your activity. Raghunath Das Goswami used to chant so many rounds, 64 rounds. She was a Premik Bhakta, not Raganuga Bhakta. She was at the level of Prema, eternal associates of Krishna. But they are doing sadhana. That is our line. We cannot give up our sadhana because we have attained some level. Sadhana continues till your last breath. Raghunath Das Goswami used to chant 64 rounds. He used to do Govardhan Parikrama. He used to offer Vaishnava Pranam 2,000 times every day. No need of any other exercise. And 1,500 times Ishtadev Pranam. And speaking about Mahaprabhu every day, 3 hours, from Chaitanya Charitamrita. And that is the material Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami got at the bank of Radhakund. And from that he compiled Chaitanya Charitamrita. So point I am trying to make, that don't be confused about Raganuga Bhakti. Raganuga Bhakti means doing sadhana under the guidance of a Ragatmika Bhakta, based on your lobha. So Mangalarti is the same. Now, as soon as alarm clock rings, we feel, oh my God, so quickly. We should sleep more, right? That is our situation as a sadhaka. But when Raganuga, they'll be waiting for Mangalarti. I don't know how many of us we really wait. When temple, we are running towards Mangalarti. We run because attendance register is there. Motivation is different, but to see Krishna, that kind of attraction, that is Raganuga Bhakti, spontaneous attraction. Then that will take us to Bhava and Prema. So Prema Bhakti is the topmost Bhakti. So after Ramananda Rai spoke about Shuddha Bhakti, then Mahaprabhu said, speak something more. Then Ramananda Rai said, Prema Bhakti Sarva Sardasar. Ultimate goal of our life is to develop prema. Prema apamartha mahan. So Mahaprabhu was very happy. Then he said, please something, speak something more. Yo hoy, age kaho ar. Then Ramananda Rai said, dasya prem sarva sadhya sar. Now rasa. There are 5 different rasas, primary rasa, santaras, dasya ras, sakha ras, Vatsala ras and Madhurya ras. And very systematically, Ramananda Rai is explaining, and Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur is giving wonderful purport about this different level. And we should also understand these principles. Since Santaras, there is no reciprocation. Santaras means you appreciate the greatness of Krishna. Just like the rivers, the trees, mountains, they appreciate Krishna appreciate greatness of Krishna, sweetness of Krishna, but they don't reciprocate, they don't serve directly. They just only do meditation, meditate the glories. So when Dasya Prem, that is the beginning of our service. There is a foundation of devotional service, Dasya Bhav. That is very prominent. We should not think in Madhurya Bhav there is no Dasya Bhav. Everything is there. In Dasya Prem, only Dasya is there. In Sakha Prem, Dasya and Sakha both are there. In Vatsalya Prem, Dasya, Sakha and Vatsalya are there. In Madhurya Prem, all four are there. That is called Madhurya Bhakti, Vatsalya Bhakti, then Sakya Bhakti and Dasya Bhakti. And also Santa. Santa is there also. They also appreciate the greatness of Krishna. So in Dasya Bhav, there is Mamata. So some relationship is there. And reciprocation is there. That is termed as Mamata. So Krishna is the master, I am the servant, I have to serve him. So that kind of mood is there. That is known as Mamata. So Mahaprabhu was happy. Then Mahaprabhu told that speak something more. Then Ramananda Rai said, Sakha Prem Sarva Saddha Sar. So serving Krishna in friendship is the essence. So in Sakya, Mamata is there, but in Sakya there is one more element. It's called Samata. Samata means equality. The devotee and Krishna come to the same platform. In Dasya Bhav, Krishna is greater, the devotee is smaller. Das Prabhu, that master and servant relationship. But in friendship, both become equal. That is called Sakya. So in Dasya, Samata is not there. In Sakya, Samata is there. But in Dasya, Mamata is there. In Sakya, Mamata and Samata, both are there. Okay, clear? Then Krishna and his devotee became equal. Don't think that we are equal, but that mood is there, equal. Krishna and me, the friends, they don't think Krishna is God, he is greater. Who are you? We are all friends. In Vaikuntha, the friends can only do handshake to with the Lord. But in Vrindavan, they can do anything. Skande Arahan, they can also, what they can do? They can climb on the shoulder. That is the meaning of friendship. Go for bhav. Then when that mood becomes more intense, then the mood of sneha develops. That is called vatsalya prem. Ramanandra says, vatsalya prem sarva saddha sar. In vatsalya prem, devotee becomes greater than Krishna. First is smaller than Krishna, then equal to Krishna, now greater than Krishna. We tell, we pray to Lord, please, my dear Lord, please protect me, please maintain me. But in Vatsalya Prem, they pray like that. What they pray? They don't pray at all. They think that Krishna has to be protected by me. Krishna should be maintained by me. If I don't give food, Krishna will starve. Krishna also feeling completely dependent. The whole world is dependent on Krishna. Whole world is praying to Krishna for protection, but Krishna is praying to Mother Yashoda for protection and maintenance. That is Vatsalya Prem. And that Vatsalya Prem is very very sweet also. There is no opulence or Aishwarya Bhav in Vrindavan, in that parental mood. I explained also, Devaki also is a mother. Mother Yashoda is also mother, but there is a difference also. Because Mother Yashoda does not have any idea that Krishna is God by the Yogamaya potency. But Devaki knows that he is my son, but at the same time, he is Supreme Personality of God. So intimacy is less. If someone is great, you cannot be intimate with. That's why you cannot be intimate with your office boss. You cannot be intimate with other superiors in your official work. Because that relationship is official. But in home, you can be very intimate. So Vrindavan is Krishna's home. And Vaikuntha is Krishna's office. That is the concept. So Mother Yashoda does not care whether Krishna is God or not. He doesn't care. His, her only thing is that Krishna is my son. I have to take care of him. And Nanda Maharaj said that I have to take care of him so that he become a human being. In Bengali he said, "Take manus korte hobe." Means you have to make him a human being. So Nanda Maharaj wants to make Krishna as a good human being. That is the mood of Vrindavan. So then, in Vatsalya Prem, that sneha is there, and because of that sneha, the devotee is thinking that I have to maintain Krishna, protect Krishna. And when the love becomes more intensified, in Vatsalya, mamata is there, samata is there, sneha is also there, but there is a mood of sankoch, means hesitation. Krishna is not willing to be completely with Mother Yashoda when he grows, he comes into Pogand and Kaushala. In the childhood, Krishna was bathed by Mother Yashoda, but when he grows, he does not allow Mother Yashoda to do that. There is some distance because of hesitation, because now he is a boy. So he doesn't want to be so close to his mother. And that happens in this world also. But the gopis' love for Krishna, in that there is no hesitation. Completely surrendered. Relationship is supremely complete. That's why gopis' love for Krishna is topmost. Then when Mahaprabhu asked, "Please speak something further," he said, "Kanta prem sarva saddhasar." The gopis' love for Krishna is topmost. And Mahaprabhu also taught us, Araddha Bhagavan Vrajasa Tanaya Taddhama Vrindavanam Ramma Kachit Upasana Vrajavadu Vargena Jakalpita Srimad Bhagavatam Pramana Mamalam Prema Pumartha Mahan Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matamidam Tatradharana Paraha. So gopis' love for Krishna is the topmost love. That is Mahaprabhu's teaching also. So why gopis' love is topmost? It's a sentiment? It's not sentiment. Mahaprabhu has given something which is unparalleled, top thing. Everything is high class. Topmost thing Mahaprabhu gave. The Lord he gave, that is Samsundar Bhagavan, he gave. He gave the topmost abode, Vrindavan Dham. He gave topmost relationship, Gopi's love. He gave the topmost literature, Vedic literature, Srimad Bhagavatam. He gave the topmost goal of all life, Prema. Everything is topmost. That is Gauriya Vaishnava line. That is Mahaprabhu's teaching. So, why Gopi's love is topmost? Krishna also told that I cannot repay na parayaham. Why he said that? Because Krishna has told Je jathamang prapadyante tang tathaiva bhajamaham. As you surrender unto me, I will reward you accordingly. But that promise failed. Krishna fails in his promise. That's why he tells the gopis, be happy with your service. I cannot pay your debt, whatever you have done. So that is the gopis' position. And Krishna wanted to establish that also. So you know this first time, but it's good to remember that. That Krishna wanted to establish also personally the gopis' position. Because while Krishna was in Dwarka, he could not sleep at night because Krishna doesn't sleep at night. Because Krishna is always active. Daytime with the cowherd boys, nighttime with the gopis. Mahaprabhu was the same. Mahaprabhu, daytime on Harinam Sankirtan on the street, nighttime in Shiva Sangam. Same, Krishna doesn't sleep. So in Dwarka, Krishna used to chant Radhe Radhe, Gopi Gopi, and queens are so curious. We are serving so nicely. 16,108 queens serving perfectly. Krishna, still Krishna is not happy, looks like. He is talking about gopis of Vrindavan. Why? Why? So there are so many pastimes, but today I'll tell the pastime how Krishna exhibited why Gopi's love is the topmost love. So Krishna showed a headache. He was having severe headache. And no medicine was working. All medicine failed. Allopathy, homeopathy, naturopathy, everything failed. So Narada Muni came. Because Narada Muni also is a great devotee of the Lord. He can travel anywhere. So Narada Muni came, started asking, "My dear Lord, how are you?" He said, "I am fine, but having headache. And the main thing is it's not going. I checked so many medicines, but it's not working." He said, "Come on, you are the Supreme Personality of Godhead. You know what is the cure." He said, "I know, but you have to arrange it." What is the cure? "The cure is very simple. If you can bring the dust of the lotus feet of my devotee, if I can put that on my head, my headache will go away. I know the medicine, but you have to arrange it." He said, "What's the big deal? Dust from the lotus feet of your devotee, nothing. It's very simple. Next door is the palace of Rukmini Devi." So he went to the palace of Rukmini Devi and gave the proposal, "Please give the dust of your wonderful lotus feet." He said, "Oh, really? Why?" Narada Muni came for the dust. "So why do you want?" He said, "Krishna has a headache, and the cure is that if you give that dust, then Krishna will put on the head, then headache will disappear." He said, "Are you okay? I worship the dust. I worship the dust of the lotus feet of Krishna. I worship his lotus feet. So how can I give my dust, which will be placed on the head of my master? Not possible. We'll go to hell." So in that way, devotees started refusing one after another, one after another. His mission failed. Narada Muni came back. So Krishna asked Narada Muni, "Where is the dust?" He said, "Not available. Nobody is willing to give." He said, "Really? So did you go to Vrindavan? Did you go to Braj?" He said, "No, I didn't go there." "So go there and try. And try with the gopis. Let's see what happens." So Narada Muni came to Vrindavan. The gopis were there at the bank of Jamuna. Radharani was also there. So they saw Radharani and gopis saw Narada Muni. They offered respect to Narada Muni. And when they came to know that he came from Dwaraka, they started asking about the position of Krishna. How is he? So Narada Muni conveyed that he is having headache and headache is not going away. So they asked what we can do. He said, Krishna said, if we can get the dust of the lotus feet of his devotee, that dust can cure his headache. Said, and Radharani said, although I am not a devotee, but Krishna considers us to be a devotee, so I am ready to give. So Radharani started giving the dust. And in Braj, there is no scarcity of dust. It is available in abundance. So Radharani started giving, and following in her footsteps, all the gopis started giving. And Narada Muni had a bag of dust. Then Narada Muni started developing doubt. He said, "They don't know scriptures, looks like. They are not gyanis. They are not knowledgeable. Simple village girls. That's why out of ignorance they are doing all this." Then Narada Muni started asking question, you don't know Shastra? You don't know the Shastra recommend? Shastra says that the dust, if goes to the head of Krishna, will go to hell. Do you know that?" He said, "Yes, we know." "Then why are you giving?" Then they told something that is really very, very deep, and it is for us to meditate on that statement. And that's why gopis are the topmost devotees. So gopis, they're telling, the pain we are experiencing now by hearing that Krishna is going through pain of headache. So as compared to that, if we suffer eternally in the hellish planet, that is nothing. That is the mood of the gopis. They are ready to suffer eternally in the hellish planet to please Krishna. They are the embodiment of the verse. Aslishva padaratang pinastumang adarshanang marmahatang karatubha jathatatava vidadhatu lampato matprananathastu savyunapara. It's not that easy. Not that easy. Vasudev Datta had the same mood. My dear Lord, he told Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the same mood of the gopis, that I'm feeling so much pain by seeing the suffering of the people of this world. So I like to take the karma of all these people and I am to suffer in the hellish planet eternally. But please deliver all of them and take them home back to Godhead. Then Hot Mahaprabhu replied that Vasudev Datta, you are the Mahabhagavat, your desire is enough. Because you desired all the souls, all the living entities of this universe is already delivered. See the potency. One desire of Mahabhagavat can deliver all the people. So gopis have the same mood. Prabhupada also had the same mood. He used to cry. He was in a car, I think in London, and he saw the people are running, roaming around, and he started crying. He said that these people, they don't know, and they're suffering so much. And that is the mood of our parampara. Preaching means having that mood of compassion to help the conditioned soul to take home back to Godhead. That's why Tabakathamritam, that verse also explains that mood. So therefore, that mood of the gopis, that they are ready to sacrifice, they are ready to sacrifice everything for the pleasure of Krishna. And when they heard the vibration of the flute of Krishna, when Krishna wanted to dance with them in rasa dance, wherever they were, whatever condition they are in, they started running. They did not think what people will think, what they will think. Never. Nothing. That's why they are the topmost devotees. But now question is, there are so many gopis. Then Mahaprabhu started asking Ramananda Rai, can you speak something more? Then Ramananda Rai was amazed. I said, I never heard that anybody can any ask question beyond gopis' love. First time I'm hearing. Then Ramananda Rai said, Radha Prem Sarva Sadhya Sar. Srimati Radharani's love for Krishna is the topmost love. So Krishna wanted to establish that also. So I'll tell a pastime to establish that. Krishna performed that pastime. So there are so many gopis, you know, that Krishna danced with how many gopis in rasa dance in this world? Satakoti, and somewhere Vishnu Chakravarti Thakur said also 3 billion gopis also, right? 3 billion, 1 billion. And out of these gopis, 108 gopis are the most important gopis. And out of 108, 8 are most confidential gopis. And out of 8, 2 are most confidential. And out of these 2, Chandravali and Radharani. Radharani is the topmost. Why? The mood. There are 2 groups of gopis. There is also group in the spiritual world. But their group is to please Krishna more, not to do politics. Here we do groups to do politics. But their group is to please Krishna more. So one is leftist doing, other one is rightist doing. 2 groups of gopis. And they fight like anything. The leader of the rightist gopis is Chandravali. And the leader of the leftist group is Radharani. The mood is rightist gopi, their mood is that we are Krishna's. That is the mood of the rightist gopis. And the mood of the leftist gopi, Krishna is mine. That is the mood. And Krishna is more attracted by this mood. That's why Radharani is superior to Chandravali. But Krishna does not give only theoretical knowledge. He wants to establish practically why Radharani is the topmost. And he wanted to show that Radharani is the topmost devotee. So one day, Krishna was glorifying Radharani like anything. Said, Radharani, you are the most beautiful. You are the most charming. You are most captivating. I am controlled by you. This, that, a list. just giving. And Radharani knows. Then Krishna said that you are so great that I am amazed by that, and I am declaring today you are greater than Mother Yashoda. As soon as Krishna said that, Radharani said, it's too much, okay? There's a limit, I know. I know you. So please don't try to spoil me by this kind of statement. He said, you don't believe my words? I'm declaring today that you are greater than Mother Yashoda, and I'll prove that. One day I'll prove that my statement is correct, that you are greater than Mother Yashoda. Again, disclaimer clause. Don't try to compare, okay? Oh, Mother Yashoda is inferior. You are trying to establish today is Radharani's day. So we have to establish her position. So one day, in the evening time, Mother Yashoda was searching for Krishna. Krishna was not visible. And was searching. And she saw that gopis and Radharani, they are there in a small group, and Krishna is also there. And Krishna was dancing. So Mother Yashoda got very upset. He said, you don't have any feeling for my Lala? Don't have any feeling for my Krishna? Whole day he was with the cows in the field, in the forest. He is so tired. Now he should take food and take rest. But you are making him dance now also. What is going on? Then gopis, headed by Radharani, said, your Krishna is a cowherd boy. He goes to the forest. But our Krishna only dances with us. You are shocked. Radharani was shocked. He said, there is two Krishna in Vrindavan. I knew that only there is one Krishna. He said, no. Our Krishna, he dances. Your Krishna grazes the cows. So really? Then where is my Krishna? He said, go and check in your house. So Mother Yashoda went back to her house. And so Krishna is there. So then she became more amazed. Said, in Vrindavan there is two Krishna, it's wonderful. I knew only one Krishna. Now one is Gopi's Krishna, is my Krishna. What's going on? Then she got an idea. She again came back to the Gopis. They said, I have a proposal that I am very happy to know that there is two Krishna in Vrindavan. So why not they develop some friendship? Let them become friends. So please bring your Krishna to my house, and my Krishna and your Krishna, let us let them become friends. I said, okay, very good idea. So the gopis brought their Krishna into the house of Nanda Maharaj, and Krishna came out from his room. Then Mother Yashoda's Krishna and Radharani's Krishna, they got introduced with each other. Radharani and Mother Yashoda did the introduction. And very good. Then Mother Yashoda said, I have another idea. So Krishna is a good dancer. So we saw only one Krishna dancing. So why not today we have a joint dance performance? Let two Krishna dance together. That will not be wonderful. So Radharani said, idea is brilliant. It's a wonderful idea, but we have one doubt. So we don't want to miss, because both Krishna look exactly the same. If both the Krishna start dancing, there can be a exchange. Maybe our Krishna can go to you and your Krishna can come to us. We don't want to take any chance. Our Krishna should be with us and your Krishna should stay with you. Then how to do that? And gopis said, we'll put a white mark on the forehead of our Krishna. That is the mark. So that Krishna is our Krishna, who has the mark, white mark on his forehead. It's very good, no problem. They put the mark, now confusion is over, no risk. Both Krishna started dancing, wonderful dance. How who can describe this kind of dance? The two Supreme Personality of Godhead, two Krishna. Radharani's Krishna and Yashoda's Krishna dancing together. And suddenly, only one Krishna. One Krishna vanished. Then Mata Yashoda started thinking. Then he started taking his that Krishna, who is Radharani said, wait. Let's check whose Krishna is this. And this mark, white mark, it's our Krishna. Then Mata Yashoda was in anxiety. Where is my Krishna? Where is my Krishna? Please give my Krishna. Please give my Krishna. Mata Yashoda started begging at the lotus feet of Radharani. And she fainted. Then Krishna was smiling. Said, what do you think? So better chant my name in the ear. Then she'll wake up and everything will be arranged. So Krishna's name was chanted. And Mata Yashoda woke up and said, your Krishna, go and check. He's taking rest in his room. So Mata Yashoda went and saw that her Krishna is beautifully lying on the bed and taking rest. And Mata Yashoda was so happy that her Krishna is there. So by this first time, Krishna is establishing that Yashoda Krishna is the manifestation of Radha's Krishna. And Radha's Krishna is the original Krishna. In that way, Radharani is the topmost devotee. Even she is greater than Mother Yashoda. So that is the conclusion by this pastime our acharyas are trying to establish that Radharani is the topmost devotee. And that Krishna, Kishore Krishna is the original form. Krishna who is dancing with the gopis is the original form of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, not the baby form of Mother Yashoda. That's why our Gaudiya Vaishnavas, we worship Radha and Krishna. The Kishore form. The eternal age of Krishna is 16. And eternal age of Srimati Radharani is 15. One year younger. Radharani is 1 year younger than Krishna. So eternally, Krishna is 16 years old, and eternally, Srimati Radharani is 15 years old. Kishore Kishori. That's why our worshipable Lord is Kishore Kishori. And that supreme couple is our worshipable object. And Mahaprabhu came to give that. Without Mahaprabhu, we cannot have any access to Srimati Radharani. That's why our Acharya sang, Jodi Gauro na hoito, tabe ki hoito kemone dhoritam de, Radharo mohima prema raso sima jagate janatake. Only Mahaprabhu can disclose Vrindavan. Only Mahaprabhu can disclose the glory of Srimati Radharani in this world. Otherwise, it is always closed. Goloka Vrindavan is always closed to the conditioned souls of this world. Only Mahaprabhu can open that door. So Mahaprabhu came and opened that door, and not only opened the door, he distributed that Braja Prema Bhakti. Anarpita charing chirat korunayavatiruna kalau samarpayita munnatujjalara sangsa bhakti sriram hari purata sundara duti kadamba sandipita sada hidaya kandare spratubasa chinandana. So that love, that Braja Prema Bhakti, gopi's love for Krishna, was not given for long, long time. Why long, long time? Because Krishna comes only once in a day of Brahma. So for long, long time it was not given. So Mahaprabhu came to give that. And not only he wanted to give, he also wanted to personally experience that. So Mahaprabhu came to distribute Braja Prema Bhakti, and he also came to experience that Braja Prema Bhakti. Krishna developed greed. I gave a whole lecture on that, but I'll speak 2-3 minutes and I conclude, time is over. So Krishna also developed greed. In order to become pure devotee, we have to develop greed. Because Raganuga Bhakti, what is the qualification? You have to develop greed, transcendental greed. Unless you develop that greed, we cannot attain Radha Krishna. So that is the mulya. And in order to, for the Lord also, in order to become devotee, he has to develop that greed. So greed is the foundation. Even a sadhaka, in order to become a pure devotee, you have to develop that greed. And for the Lord to become devotee, he has to develop that greed. What is the greed? Because Krishna gave a big lecture in Bhagavad Gita, no? भक्तरांग भक्तराम जगत वसांग सर्वलोक महेश्वरम सुविधां सर्वभूतानां गत्तमां शांति मिच्छति. ही सेड आई एम द सुप्रीम एंजॉयर. बट वन डे ही वाज अट्रैक्टेड बाय द ब्यूटीफुल फॉर्म, ए ब्यूटीफुल बॉय, एंड ही वाज रनिंग बियॉन्ड दैट बॉय. एंड आफ्टर रनिंग फॉर सम टाइम ही स्टार्टेड रियलाइजिंग दिस इज द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ हिज ओन बॉडी. ही सेड ओ माय गॉड, आई थॉट आई एम गॉड. But I am not God. I declare that I am the supreme enjoyer. But I don't know my beauty. I don't know my sweetness. What kind of God I am? I am incomplete God. So Krishna started feeling incompleteness as a supreme personality of God. He said, what is the use to be a God? I don't know my beauty. I am not enjoying more than me. My devotees, Srimati Radharani, gopis, they are enjoying much more than me. So what is the use to be a God? So I want to become a devotee. That's why Prabhupada used to say that whole world wants to become God, but God wants to become devotee. So who is greater? I always give the example. Prabhupada gave this example also. Sweetness. Krishna is sweet like Rasgulla. Today is the day of Radharani cooking. Rasgulla is very sweet. So how sweet Rasgulla is? Who can understand? Rasgulla can understand? I'm very sweet? No. So who can taste it? Who can understand it? Who will eat it? So Krishna is like Rasgulla. Devotees are like eater. So Krishna developed that desire that I am so sweet, but I am not able to experience that sweetness because I am God. And who can experience that? Who is my devotee? And who can experience the most? The supermost devotee, Srimati Radharani. So he developed desire, rather greed, to become Srimati Radharani. That's why Chaitanya Charitamrita explains that Mahaprabhu came to experience these three things. Experience that three lovers, that three transcendental greed. Sri Radhaya Pranaya Mohima Kidrisha Banaiva Saddha Janadbhuta Madhurima Kidrisha Vamodhya Sakkhan Chasya Madhana Bhavata Kidrishang Vetti Lobhat Tad Bhavadda Samaja Nisachi Garbha Sindhu Harindu. So Mahaprabhu came to experience three things. The glory of Srimati Radharani's love. First. Second, he wanted to experience the sweetness of Krishna. Sweetness of him. And also he wanted to experience the happiness which was experienced by Srimati Radharani by rendering devotional service to Krishna. So these are the three things Krishna wanted to experience. And in order to experience that, he assumed the form of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So what is Srimati Radharani's love? Glory of Srimati Radharani's love? Because Radharani was in separation. Krishna Prema can be experienced in Sambhoga and Vipralamba. So when Akrura took away Krishna out of Vrindavan, the gopis, especially Radharani and all other gopis also, they were in separation from Krishna because they cannot stay a moment in separation from Krishna. Now Krishna is taken away from Vrindavan. So they are not able to survive. But Krishna told that I'll come back. So situation of the gopis is that they cannot live because without Krishna they cannot live. And they cannot die also because Krishna told he'll come back. So they cannot live, they cannot die. So what they can do? They can cry. That is our parampara. Gauriya Vaishnava parampara means crying out for Krishna. That's why Gaura Govinda Maharaj used to say that I opened a school where people can cry. Crying school. The price to enter into Vrindavan. Only one price. Cry for Krishna. Then he may say, Prabhuji, aata nahi. Rona aata nahi. Jab kuch kho jata hai, rona aata hai. Krishna ke liye rona nahi aata hai. We don't feel to cry. That's why you should pray to Krishna that I am so unfortunate. Even after chanting the holy name, even after hearing your pastime, I am not able to cry. That's why I should cry. And even after that you don't cry, again you pray. In that way, at one point we have to cry. Because that is the price. And when Mahaprabhu took sannyas, one of the purpose of Mahaprabhu's taking sannyas is to make the devotees of Navadvip to cry. Even the critics, they started crying when Mahaprabhu left Navadvip Dham. Because he wanted to experience. He wanted to experience and he wanted to make Navadvip devotees also to experience what is the meaning of Radharani's love, the glory of Srimati Radharani's love. So first purpose of Mahaprabhu's coming is to experience the love of Srimati Radharani and also to experience the sweetness of Krishna and wanted to experience the happiness of Radharani. And because of that, Krishna came as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And that same Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave that love to each and everyone by congregational chanting of the holy name. We can experience that. And that's why Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, if you want to develop Vraja Prema Bhakti, you have to completely dedicate yourself in the Sankirtan mission of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. By congregational chanting of the holy name, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And this Harinam Sankirtan is Golokera Premadhan Harinam Sankirtan. If we take part in this, then our life will be successful and we can attain the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna and we can go back to our eternal abode of Goloka Vrindavan. And that will be the success of our life. As the follower of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, as Gauriya Vaishnava, that is the perfection, attaining the lotus feet of Srimati Radharani. And that should be our only goal. The lotus feet of Srimati Radharani should be the only object of meditation as a Gauriya Vaishnava. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Srimati Radharani ki jai, Radhashtami Mahamahotsav ki jai, Nitai Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari Bol.